Hey there. Hi, Tom. This is Shawna Karrasch here, and I'm answering an Ask Shawna answer from Villanova. and you say, I've been listening to your podcast and watching YouTube videos, and I've learned a lot. Thank you. Thank you. I have a six-year-old off-the-track thoroughbred. I've been with him almost 2 years. I use both positive and negative reinforcement in his training, and we have done nearly 100 trail riding. Wow, he has improved a lot and has been fantastic most of the time. He's very hot and sensitive nature. He responds to my body language and energy very well, but when he sees other horses on trail, can be 200 meters away, which is far, running around, or his mate horse in front starts cantering or takes off and jumps a log or gets very excited. He gets very excited and nervous and he wants to take off and start jigging. Sometimes he bolts if I don't hold him well. I think it is a common issue for off-the-track thoroughbreds. How would you address this using positive reinforcement? I think this is a great question, but what I would do, because definitely could do it, what he's showing is that it has served him better to run during those times of excitement, which doesn't really make, you know, it's not so surprising with, you know, typically how they're, when they race. But he, especially if he's sensitive. So he might think, oh, we're going to go into racing mode. And so he's trying to just get it right. So he finds it serves him better. It's more reinforcing, whether it's negative reinforcement or not. It serves him better to move and be active when other horses are active. What I would suggest you do is get to a place and where you're adding to his excitement because he's out on the trail. And then when he's out on the trail, there's a lot to look at and a lot to take in. So that can be kind of adding to that nature. So what I would do is be sure you've done good with the positive reinforcement and the bridge conditioning, which you've got if you're listening to my podcast. And then he's good with the target and the liberty leading. Those little pieces are fundamental, but it sounds like you know all about those. So that's good. But what I would start doing is I would start having in a place where he's most comfortable, most quiet. If you have an arena, I would do it in an arena. If you don't have an arena, and you're going to need a friend for this, if you don't have an arena, find a place where he rides well outside, which is quite comfortable, and you can do a little bit of repetition. So you're not taking him into a whole bunch of new exciting things. And what I would do is I would ask, and you know what? You could even do this without a rider at first, where you are on the ground and you're just holding him and have your friend just start to trot far as he possibly can be away and you reinforce him for relaxation during the trot. Look for those eyes, those ears, the softness, the head instead of like this, the head starts to go down just a little. Might not be perfect, but it can improve. So I would have your friend, and I would do this for some repetition because it sounds like it's very strong response in him right now. And so he thinks, I got to go. So what you want to do is you want to teach him a new response. You want to change the reinforcement history and teaching him, instead of coping with that, you know, anxiety situation, but instead of bolting with it, his new coping mechanism is to take a deep breath, to relax, to stop a little bit, to slow down, to think about staying with you, to focus on you. And so what I would do in the beginning is you can just stand and hold him. Now, I'm going to tell you, it might be a trigger that it's when the rider is on that he feels like this. He may be okay with you standing on the ground because if it is racetrack oriented, he had a rider. And so that may be part of it, but I don't care. If you start with him on the ground and you work on him just being relaxed, even though you may not see the same response that you would when you're under saddle with him, you're still getting a chance to build a new and improved reinforcement history with standing quietly with activity going on. When that activity goes well, you could maybe have him canter in a circle over there and then shift directions and you get a little bit closer and a little bit closer. But there is one caveat. I don't want you to move to the next step until the previous step is solid and consistent. So maybe you get really good at this. He goes like, okay, he's not going to hurt me. I'm okay. It doesn't mean start there for your next session because he learned it in that context. So I would wait till you can start over. You can start there and he doesn't react at all. Then you think, okay, now that we can start there and he doesn't react at all, we could probably start a little bit further apart. But remember, it's tiny increments because this is really pretty conditioned in him right now. So build up those tiny increments, build up his reinforcement history with standing quietly. When your friend can ride by you and do it from different areas of the arena or the pasture, wherever you are, and when your friend can ride by you at different areas and different speeds, then and even set up a little jump and have him jump a little jump, first way far away and then slowly getting closer. When he can do all that from the ground, I would then begin to do it from the saddle. And at first, you might just be standing. Sometimes standing for a thoroughbred's really challenging because they're like, I want to go, you know. So sometimes walking in a nice little circle might be a place for him to put his energy, but to keep it together. Some of them, though, it helps them to stand and just watch everything and not, you know, just have one piece to consider. So you got to know him and what he does, which after 100 times of trail riding, I'm sure you do know him. So I would build up to that till you can do it under saddle, and you can be standing or walking or doing mild stuff yourself until you can build up your activity and his activity. When that is going good, I would even have your friend riding by. So, and at first just walking by, and then trotting by, and then cantering by. So he can learn, if anything, I would rather see activity and stop. So I would rather reinforce him for downward transition, for standing quietly, and really build relaxation into his ridden work and into his everyday groundwork. So that he, like when you're riding, you know, when you're riding, you feel your horses like this, and then you can tell when they kind of just soften just a little. I bridge that a lot because I want them to be soft and relax. I want relaxed energy because I like energetic horses, actually. But I want it to be relaxed energy. I don't want it to feel tense energy. So those moments when you can feel him relax, really work on relaxation as part of it. Times he kind of drops his head a little bit and he takes a deep sigh and he softens his shoulders, or, you know, any piece that you can tell that's showing relaxation, I would really reinforce that. So it's just shifting things, and you're going to kind of have an exercise to work through a little bit to help change what has been pretty strongly conditioned in him. I'm sure he's had years of the other being what his response was supposed to be. And now it's going to take a little bit for you to unpack that and help him to learn a new way to cope with that lit up situation. Okay, Tom, that's a great question. If you have more questions, you know how to get a hold of me. You can go to Ask Shawna if you go to vianovatraining.com or Shawna Karrasch. com. You will find the Ask Question or Ask Shawna, and that's where you can submit your questions. So thank you for asking, and I would love to hear an update on how your guy is coming along and how that goes for him and for both of you. Anyway, all right, thanks a lot. Till next time. Bye-bye.